Hi friends and YouTube viewers and my dear students. Today I am going to discuss about the most important topic, that is translation or protein synthesis. What is protein synthesis? It is the process of translation of nucleotide language of mRNA into amino acid language by tRNA is called translation. There are only 20 amino acids are biologically important in the participation of protein synthesis. So, what are the minimum requirements of this translation mechanism helped in? At first, activated amino acids and all types of RNA, mRNA, tRNA, rRNA, energy molecules, ATP, GTP, and enzymes, amino acyl synthetase, amino acid activating enzymes, and peptidyl 1 synthetase enzyme. Peptidyl 1 synthetase enzyme, and including this, magnesium ions and inorganic factors and releasing factors and inorganic elements are must and should require for this process. What are the steps involved in translation? Translation is involved by four important steps: activation of amino acids, initiation of polypeptide chain, elongation of polypeptide chain, and termination of polypeptide chain. I'll explain very clearly, step by step, in a systematic way. First one, activation of amino acids. So generally, amino acids are present in the cytoplasm or they are inactive in stage, which means they are combined with the energy molecule in the presence of the enzyme amino acyl synthetase and magnesium ions, forming an activated amino acid that is carried by amino acyl adeninylate and phosphate. That is, the equation stands like this: amino acid plus ATP gives less to adenosine monophosphate amino acid plus diphosphate. Means ATP has three phosphate bonds. First and third bond is broken as diphosphate, and middle bond is formed as AMP, adenosine monophosphate. And this activated amino acid then combines with the third prime end of tRNA. It forms the complex, that is amino acyl tRNA complex or charged RNA, and AMP is released. The equation is showing like this: adenosine monophosphate amino acid tRNA complex in the presence of amino acyl tRNA synthetase, it forms AATRNA, which means activated amino acid tRNA complex plus AMP. So this is the first step, that is activation of amino acid. And second step, initiation of polypeptide chain. It is the process the mRNA gets attaches to 30S ribosome subunit. tRNA carries one activated amino acid and methionine gets attaches to the first codon. It acts as a initiating codon. It takes place in the presence of energy molecule, that is GTP, and initiating factor, inorganic factors, we can say, that is IF1, IF2, IF3 respectively. At this time, 50S ribosome unit is combined with 30S ribosome unit to form 70S ribosome structure, which means the first tRNA amino acid complex is now at the P site of ribosome unit. The formation of ribosome unit is helped by rRNA, that is ribosomal RNA. So this is the second step, initiation of polypeptide chain. And third step, elongation of polypeptide chain. Each ribosome contains two sites, that is P site and A site. P site is stands for polypeptide site and A site is for amino acid site. At A site, tRNA with attached by polypeptide, P site and tRNA amino acid complex just arises at the A site. The polypeptide is transferred and attached by a peptide bond to the newly arrived amino acid. Once the process is carried, entire how many codons are present on the mRNA strand that is continuously translated by mRNA that is moves across to the A site and immediately it empty of P site. The first tRNA is released through one amino acid that is glycine, what I shown in the figure. So like that all amino acids are formed by carrying of tRNA molecule and activated amino acid at the A site and processed by P site and entire the codons are completed. The same tRNA from the fifth prime end is carried by another codon that is called stop codon that is UAA and UAG and UGA. So that is Archi, Opal and Amber. So these are stopping codons. Once the stopping codon is the terminating codon is arrived at the E site, immediately this polypeptide chain elongates through the mRNA. Last step, that is termination and relation of polypeptide chain. The arrival of terminating codon on mRNA at A site. The terminating codon may be UAA, UAG and UGA. These codons do not code for any amino acid. During this process, one activated enzyme is functionized, peptidyl synthetase catalyzer. So, which catalyzes the cleavage of polypeptide, which means broken off, termination of polypeptide chain from the last tRNA. Which means the polypeptide chain is finally released. Therefore, after completion of this process, mRNA move towards and ribosome units are deattaches and a newly formed synthesized protein polypeptide chain is released into the cell. In this way, the translation takes place. Apart from this most important memorizable two words are important for CET and NEET. The speed of transcription and translation in bacterial cell per second it carried by 30 nucleotides. The speed of transcription and translation in bacteria that is carried by 20 amino acids. These two points are very very important. Memorize, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get latest notifications and buy them and have a nice day. Wish you good luck. Mera bhai.